Hey, what's up everybody? Joshua Casper back at you with Plugin Boutique, and today we've got a brand new Kontakt instrument library to check out from Audiomodern called Opacity. This is a boutique collection of cinematic guitar and professional six-string performances that sound absolutely fantastic. You have a ton of control to make really nice, unique performances with all of the different variations of the different performances built into the instrument at your disposal. Opacity comes with 14 complete sessions with over 800 loop performances divided into four main categories: chords, phrases, sequences, textures. You get 5.6 gigabytes of sounds, individual effects chains for each group, and even a custom convolution reverb with a ton of impulse responses built inside. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through the instrument. It's very straightforward, very easy to use, and I'm going to play you some of the sounds built inside of it. Let's go ahead and jump into it. All right, everybody, so this is Opacity here on the screen. Very, very cool instrument. As I said, 14 different performances. Three of them have two variations. If you click right here, you can actually see those. All of them are helpfully labeled with the original BPM and the key of the track. Now, obviously, BPM doesn't matter. I can move my BPM here and it will transpose inside of the project easily enough. However, having the original BPM is always a good starting point and good information to have in the beginning, right? So each of those sessions is broken up into four different subsections: chords, phrases, sequences, and swells. Now, each one of those has a number of different variations. So if you look down here inside of Kontakt, there are four groups color-coded. Each one of these corresponds to each one of these groups. So phrases would be purple. And you have all of these different variations meant for the same performance. So it'll be in the same key, the same sort of feel, one for your bridge and one for your verse or your breakdown or however you see fit to sequence these things. And having this amount of different options available to you that are already meant to go together gives you an incredible amount of control to make something unique. All right, so that's just a preview of some of the different variations inside of this session 10. However, if you do want to mix and match, you can actually come in here and you can see I can go to session 4 chords if I wanted to. Now I'm inside of there, and these are session 4 chords as opposed to session 10 chords. And it's very helpful. It says SO4. You can see it right there. You do want to be mindful of the different keys. Some of them will go together. Some of them will play nice. Some of them might not. You know, you need to use your discretion there, but having the ability to mix and match is a very, very cool thing to have. Now, each of these four groups has its own effects panel. You can turn the effects off or on right here. And right here, we're looking at the effects panel down here. We've got space, which is your convolution reverb. I believe there are like 30 different ones. You can't quote me on that number. However, you can see that there are quite a lot of impulse responses at your disposal. You've got controls over those. You've got a crush down here with glitch and noise, delay, a drive, chorus, panning, a stutter effect, and a filter with low pass, high pass, and band pass with cutoff and resonance. Very straightforward stuff. So each one of these has its own. So if I click right here, you can see that delay has changed over here. If I turn the delay on, maybe switch the rate, and then go back to one, you'll see that it's different. So each one of these corresponds to each one of these groups. All right, very, very straightforward. Now there is a cabinet panel here as well, where you can choose from a number of different cabinets that are emulations of very, very popular cabinet units, okay? So it's a really nice touch to get that extra realism to the performance of these guitars. And you've got your size, your air, rotator, speed, balance, distance, and the wet dry mix. So how do you use this to get a performance like the one I had here in the beginning of the video? So what I'm gonna do is I already had a performance inside of the MIDI. I'm gonna jump into that MIDI in a second, but what I wanna show you is that I can just switch from, say, session 10 to randomly picking another one Or it might be good to stay around the same BPM. So let's go up to 14 and just see what it sounds like. And I haven't changed any of the MIDI, but we should get an entirely new track. All right, let's try out 11. I mean, that sounds utterly fantastic. There's no way around that. That sounds brilliant. And let's just check out 5 for the sake of it. Is that not super dope? So the way this is done inside of Ableton Live, if I come over here, let's move this over so we can see it while we still see the instrument. Okay, so I have a MIDI clip here. I guess I am gonna have to close it. Now you can play opacity like an instrument. You can turn it on to loop. You can there's a hold function. You can turn velocity sensitivity on or off inside of the instrument. But the way I like to kind of start getting the idea when I'm using it for production is just to jump into a MIDI clip here. Okay, so to start making a project with opacity, right? You want to open up your MIDI clip, and obviously this keyboard inside of my MIDI clip corresponds to the same keyboard inside of the Contact player. So let's just go ahead and delete stuff and get started. I kind of like to start with the sequences because I think that's kind of like the bed of the track. So what I do is just play that. You know, maybe that's your intro, and then you slide back into, and you could put in some chords or some phrases. And this would be good with like a swell to come into it. Maybe break it down like this, move this over, take the drum loop and start it after. Let's initialize that, and let's just listen to what we got. And boom, and that's kind of how you get started, right? If you just come in here, you know, you got your chords down here at C1, maybe drop a chord as like a fill before the drums come in. Yeah. And of course, the velocity sensitivity is on, so I can take my velocity and pull it down so it doesn't have to be quite so loud. And we're already started here making some sort of ambient track, right? It's that simple. Now, one of the, you know, if we jump back into the Contact player here, let's jump into, again, session 10 and see what that sounds like. Very, very cool stuff. And that's really all there is to it. You've got a ton, like I said, 800 individual audio files to mix and match to make your production. And having, you know, 800 divided by 14, I don't know what that is, but that many different audio slices that are meant to be put together like a puzzle piece, and you've got yourself a very, very powerful and yet easy to use Contact instrument. Now, this is obviously more for chill out, ambient style stuff, maybe scores for film, video games, whatever you want to do. Opacity is an incredible instrument to have in your musical library. Anyway, I'm Joshua Casper here for Plugin Boutique. I hope you learned something. I hope you like the sounds of Opacity. Links in the video description if you want to check it out. and I'll see you in the next video.